everybody. It is December 6th, Friday, December 6th. We just got into the tree stand. I'm down on the old nursery property, and I have the day off work today, so I'm going to do some hunting. I'm also using a 223 today. I'm going to try something different. I've talked about doing it for a long time. Essentially, you just have to be on your mark. There's not a lot of room for error like it would be with a 180 grain 30-06. So I have to have pinpoint accuracy today. And there's no reason that 223 can't drop a doe. So I'm going to sit back, let it get light, and hopefully we see some deer today. Those deer are gonna end up right down here. That bulldozer right over there. Mention, for anyone who doesn't know or is new to the channel, So, back in the tree, I'll be able to see. I can see my truck from here. I'll be able to see when my mom shows up. So, I have about another hour and a half done. We could technically put another deer down. So, at the very least, hopefully, we get to see some more deer. Just watch the video back. I don't like that. That deer didn't go right down. Really don't like that, but I don't know what happened with that damn gun. From the last time I shot, it never put another bullet in. Gosh, that's the first time I've ever had a gun do that. I can't believe I just doubled up on doe. I'm gonna watch the video back a couple more times probably. So, try to figure out where I hit her. Of course it's out of focus. I mean, she jumps and kicks pretty good, so I'm confident that I hit her. I'm gonna go over there now. My mom's on her way with my kid. I'm gonna go over there and see if I can see any hair or some blood. So, hopefully she didn't go far. Well, that's not the hit that I wanted. A lot of white hair. I'm gonna back out. A lot of white hair. It could have hit and ricocheted out the bottom, I don't know. But I don't want to go pushing her. While I give that deer time, I'm also transferring the video to my phone just so I can see it on a bigger screen. So while I'm doing that, I'm packing up and we're gonna go back to the truck, grab my mom and my son. I'm really hoping that second deer is down. I for sure hit her because of the hair. I'm not a fan of the white hair. The video's out of focus. But she definitely took off like there was a problem. So last thing you want to do is rush this, have her go into the neighbor's property or something stupid. I still don't know what the hell happened with the first deer and that gun not getting loaded. That's not good. But I'm gonna wrap everything up here.
What do you think?
A doe.
A doe? Yeah, you're smart. Oh, nice doe. Yeah, that's where Daddy hit her. Yeah? Yeah? She's nice. She's gonna taste good. Huh? She gonna go good in your belly?
Can you say thank you?
Say thank you. Say thank you.
I'm good.
Hey, say thank you. Thank you. Nice deer. Oh my.
A doe.
A doe, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yep, a doe. All right, we're gonna go try to recover this other deer. Hopefully she's down.
Yeah, so that's where I hit her. And she ran that way. And I said I came over
There's
here.
There's another trap here.
All right, well, first of all, let me apologize for the wind noise. Secondly, I've been tracking this deer, and I'm going to show you guys what I found. So, she went in through here. Somewhere in here, there's one leaf with the tiniest little drop of blood on it. Oh, it's right up here. Right there, guys. You see that blood there? So, I had to sit... The direction. I knew she came up through here. So she cut through all this, I'm thinking. Up through here, straight up through here. I don't really remember where it went from here. But all through here, I didn't have any blood. So I started just doing like body search. Body. So, oh, look. Looks like that might be a little bit of hair there. I don't know. I found a little tuft of hair. And I just started doing little circles trying to figure out where the deer would have went. And came down here. And here's where I had found my first blood. Also, on the neighbor's property. They're not home. I've looked and looked with my binoculars trying to find the deer in their yard. And I can't find any more blood bloods. I don't know what else to do. I wish there was something else I could do. But I can't just go onto their property. It's a really bad situation, guys. So, I'm gonna go back, get that deer gutted up and whatnot, and I wish there was something else I could do with this deer. I don't think she's dead. I honestly don't, just because, like, she's walking in through here. I think she's okay. I think I hit her back a little too far. So, I feel terrible. I don't like doing that. I don't like messing up.
Okay.
I'm coming. A doe. You never know how out of shape you are until you have to drag a deer, right? Definitely not the way I wanted the day to go. I hope you guys can see, like, trying to be very transparent with you guys. I feel terrible about that deer. There's not a whole lot else you can do. I mean, I grid searched the woods. I trailed her. I'm almost positive she at the very least made it over to the neighbors. Who knows where she might still be alive. I don't know. But I did want to cover something with you guys. This morning, when the doe that I shot and I did get
came out, four other bucks were trailing her. And it didn't dawn on me right away, but I'm pretty sure the doe that I shot was in heat. Which is very odd. Very, very odd. For this late in the year. That's the only reason I can think that four bucks were following her. It's because she was in heat. So, kind of weird. Never experienced anything like that before. So, it was an interesting morning, to say the least. 223 works pretty well. I don't think I had the right shot placement, I guess. I'm just going to make it my fault. I didn't do a good enough job. Yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate all the new subscribers. We are racing towards that 1,000 subscriber mark, and it is unbelievable. So thank you guys again. I love you all. I'll see you later.